Pounds, and it's a genuine coal-fired, steam-driven Type 282 locomotive. That 282 simply means there's two wheels on the front, two on the back, and eight large drive wheels in the middle. After Engine 70 was completed, it was shipped to Skagway, Alaska, where it worked on the bypass and Yukon Railroad.
Thank you.
Cowdeese Mountains, the place of the blue smoke. The Smoky Mountains are the natural habitat for more flowering plants and trees than anywhere else in the United States. Even in the air, you can hear them use over 200 species of birds. The Smokies are a never-ending song. They change with each season and with each pair of eyes. Cinderella, and sometimes we like to make some noise about it. So what do you say, folks? Would you like to hear the engineer play a tune on that wobbling of water whistle? All right, on the count of three, let's all yell, blow the whistle. 1, 2, 3, blow the whistle. Soaring 21 stories above the floor of the Great Smoky Mountains, it's the Wild Eagle. You'll drop 13 stories as you fly up to speeds of 63 miles an hour. It has a 110-foot giant loop. It might be the most exciting 2 minutes and 22 seconds of your life. How many people rode the Wild Eagle? How many people are big chickens to ride the Wild Eagle? Oh, the chickens win again. Well, you can go in the merchandise shop. They have big yellow t-shirts that says, I'm a chicken. Well, now it's time for some train music. tune in to Wake Up Fire from Stephen. He's the one responsible for getting us all up here today by hand shoveling all the coal into the firebox. This engine operates the same way today as it did when it was first built. And on a busy day, Cinderella would use 5 tons of coal, 5,000 gallons of water, and she'll bring 4,000 to 5,000 people up the mountain. We're real proud of our engine and the guys that operate them. We hope you enjoy riding behind them just as much as we do.